بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. My dear audience, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Mamdouh Muhammad in a short lecture titled The Role of the Sunnah in Uniting the Ummah, the Nation. And I think we badly need this topic in order to know the simplest recipe in order to unite the Ummah, not only in a small place but on a large scale. You can say it's almost said everywhere that the human being is a social being. That is, he cannot live by himself. In other words, he cannot live independent of others. Almost in every culture, the thinkers, the educators, the average human beings can tell you that. Man is a social being. A human being needs a spouse, a husband or a wife. Otherwise, the whole human race will extinguish and end. There will be no human life on earth. And the two spouses, you can see that they are related physically and emotionally to each other. This is the simplest form of unity. The physical relationship, which can be shown in a marital or parental or maternal relationship. On another scale, you see that people are united by location. That is, they are from the same place, from the same alley, from the same street, from the same village, from the same town, or from the same country. And in this way, they can relate to each other. They can say, we are from Senegal, we are from China, we are from Morocco. Language is another factor that unites people. People who speak the same language can communicate and relate well to each other. So this is another way of uniting people. Race is also a factor. Common history is another factor in uniting people. Common goals, the same vision of people can unite them. All these are considered factors of uniting people. However, unity among Muslims may look rather complex simply because they speak different languages, almost all the languages that are spoken on the earth. They are from all the races that live on this planet. They belong to all these countries in the world. They are from Pakistan, they are from the United States of America, they are from Russia, they are from Japan. So there's a lot of complexities apparently. However, there is a very simple way to unite them. It's not based on the language, it's not based on the race, it's not based on location. It's something more important. It is the same belief. Yes, we can say the Muslims share the same beliefs. However, there is an important element in uniting the whole Muslim communities. It is following the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that helps a lot, making the Muslims do the same practices that they do everywhere. When Muslims from every corner in the world do the same practices of the messenger of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they become more and more united, and they become strongly united. When a Muslim from Bangladesh visits Somalia or Senegal or Latin America, he or she would find all the Muslims in those countries pray in the same way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. They would find the Muslims would make the same adhan that was done at the same time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They would find the Muslims make the same takbir and the same ruku'ah and the same sujood and the same taslim. And when they find this in front of them, they feel more comfortable because of the familiarity of the practices. There is not a big difference, a big change between what they do in Bangladesh and what they have seen in these places that I mentioned. And in this way, they feel more united and strongly united. On the contrary, when a Muslim visits another masjid in the same city or in a different country, and when he or she finds a lot of differences in the practices of the ibadah, especially ibadah like salat, for example, in some cases we find Muslims doing strange things. We find an imam, when he finishes the salat, turns towards his followers and he starts whispering some du'as, unclear du'as to everyone. And in most of the time they make these du'a in Arabic and everyone expected to say Ameen even if they don't understand. This is not the tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We may find another imam in another masjid who would raise his hands before the salat and after the iqama, and he would make a specific dua that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not do. Again, this is not the tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When a Muslim goes to such a masjid or such a place and he finds the Muslims there are doing different practices, especially in the most common ibadah, which is the salat, it becomes a disunifying factor. It becomes a factor that disunites the Muslims. To unite the Muslims, an average Muslim would suggest this simple recipe. Follow the authentic sunnah and keep away from the inherited cultural practices away. Very easy, very clear, very simple. In a society like the United States, Muslims are luckier, especially the new generations who are driven to the love to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when I say the sunnah, I definitely mean the authentic sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These generations, the young generations, they succeeded to quit many unauthentic practices brought by their fathers from their countries or from back home. They do believe, those people who belong to the new generations, they do believe that the shortcut path to unity of Muslims is going back to basics, back to one man who had been selected by Almighty Allah to be our role model. Follow this role model, and if we do the following, everywhere in the world, we feel that the similarities between the Muslims are so high, and we feel that we are among our brothers and sisters who do the same thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. So the simple formula of uniting Muslims is just hold hard, bite on the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do as he did and keep away from things that he did not. This is Dr. Mamduh Muhammad. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Peace be unto all of you.